Good morning, Dons. Welcome back to another episode of CCTV. I'm Jack Freem.
And I'm Julia Way. We hope you've all had a stellar week, Dons.
To all of those who have chosen to take AP tests this week, we know you guys did great.
And to all of those who are taking them next week, keep studying and good luck.
Now, let's go to our news team who found out about the art showcase and concert coming up on campus.
Hey, Dons. I'm here with Ms. Swift, the director of music, to hear about the art show. So, Ms. Swift, what's happening next week?
Thanks for asking. Next week, we have an exciting event on Wednesday night. There's going to be a reception in which you can see all of the artwork representing all of our current visual arts students in the lobby of the theater. And then there'll be a concert at 7 p.m. So 5:30 to 7, free food, artwork, and then a free show.
Sounds exciting. Is there anything that's carrying on since last year that we're going to see this year?
Yeah, so each year we've traditionally shown artwork in the lobby, but last year was the first year we did a concert, and we'll continue to see the same groups plus Scola, singer-songwriters, and we're also going to have an opportunity to even purchase some of the artwork on some materials like mugs and shoes through a program we're doing called Artsonia.
Awesome. And if we can't make the event, is there anywhere else we could see the art?
You certainly can. Just swing by the theater lobby anytime on Tuesday, Wednesday, or Thursday, and the artwork will be displayed there those 3 days.
Awesome. Come support your local artist, Dons. With CCTV, I'm Kiana Schaman. Back to you in the anchor room.
Thanks, ladies.
Remember, tomorrow's an SAT test, so good luck to anybody taking it.
And remember, next Saturday, the 14th, is the seniors' Knott's Berry Farm trip.
Can't wait. I love the accelerator.
Not a big coaster fan myself.
Well, it'll be a great time either way.
Now let's go to Arcelita and find out the light news on campus.
Good morning, Dons. I'm Arcelita Martin, and I'm happy to welcome you back to another segment of CCTV Light. The saint of the week is St. Catherine of Bologna. Being the patroness of artists, send a prayer to St. Catherine of Bologna for all of the artists here on our campus and those showcasing their work next Wednesday at the Art Festival. Now, for more news on the religious happenings here on campus, let's check in with Amanda Wright and Delaney Grazier.
Miss Connolly, I had the best time at prom last weekend.
Delaney, I thought prom was 2 weekends ago.
No. I went to a night to remember prom.
What's that?
Let's go to Amanda, who learned more about it.
Good morning, Dons. I'm here with Katie to learn about the A Night to Remember prom. Katie, what is it?
The Night to Remember prom is a prom for special needs students where they get to experience prom in a special, unique way.
That's super cool. And what do you do there?
You get to dance with the kids. The kids get pampered. They get limo rides. They have a paparazzi. They get their hair and makeup done for the girls. And it's just a lot of fun for the hosts and the students.
Wow, what a cool opportunity. And when is it?
The prom was this past weekend, so signups will be next January for next year in May.
Awesome. And can you get service hours?
Yes, you get service hours for it, and it's a super good way to get involved in your community and have a lot of fun doing it.
Love it. Students, make sure you get involved in this super fun service opportunity. For CCTV Light, I'm Amanda Wright. Back to you, Arcelita.
Thanks, Amanda and Delaney. The Caritas Award Luncheon is Monday during lunch in the chapel. Please be sure to RSVP to Mr. Hurt if you haven't done so already. And as students finish the second week of AP testing, CCTV Light wishes focus and clarity to all students. And that's all the news I have for you this week, Dons. I'm Arcelita Martin for CCTV Light, wishing you a delightful weekend. Now, back to Jack and Julia.
Thanks, Arcelita.
Tomorrow's the Dons Dash, so get ready to run for a great cause.
Speaking of running, let's go to Cole and CCTV Sports.
How y'all feeling, Dons? I'm Cole Mueller, and welcome back to some spring sports news. Dons baseball has been doing pretty solid, with some good wins against Saints and modern-day Chula Vista. They play today at 3:30 at home against Mira Mesa, so good luck to them. Your Lady Dons softball team is killing it, with an overall record of 21-3-1. And they are undefeated with a brilliant record of 9-0 in league. They're on a crazy 15-game winning streak right now, and they play Point Loma today at 3:30 at home, so come and support your ruling Dons softball team as they try to keep their winning streak alive. Now, here's Hayden Adriano with some news on your girls' swim team.
What splashes through the water? Our Lady Dons swim team. Let's splash it on to Adriana where she has more.
I'm here with two captains of your varsity girls swim team, Cora and Maddie. So Cora, how do you guys prepare for a race?
Every girl kind of gets ready for a race in their own different ways, but for me personally, I always like to turn my goggles like binoculars.
That's very interesting. And Maddie, how's the season going so far?
The season's going really well. We have a really strong group of girls this year, and we're undefeated right now. We're looking really good for CIFs.
That's awesome. And where are you guys committed?
I committed to UC Davis.
I committed to CSU Bakersfield.
Well, congrats to you guys both. For CCTV, I'm Adriana. Back to you, Cole.
Thanks, Hayden and Adriana. Some surf news now. Your Dons competed in the Division III state championships, and your very own women's longboard team got all the way to the semifinals. The team was led with some amazing surfing by team members Carly Bizak and Keely and Hannah McKevely. And girls shortboard, once again, surfers Carly Bizak, Hannah McKevely, and Mackenzie Davey got all the way to the finals, sharing against Capo Valley High School, and they placed first and third, securing the state championship for the second year in a row. Well, that's a wrap for this week. Now back to you in the anchor room.
Thanks, Cole.
Hey, Julia, you know, I love reducing.
No way, I love reusing.
You know what we love?
Recycling! Let's go to our freelance team who found out more.
I know I can't take one more step towards you, 'cause all that's waiting is regret. And don't you know I'm not your ghost anymore? You lost the love I love the most. I learned to live half alive, and now you want me one more time. And who do you think you are, running around leaving scars, collecting your jar?
Hey Dons, Francesca Federico here with Miss Anna Carrico, the AP Environmental Science teacher and club moderator for the Environmental Club. So Miss A, what are some tips to help recycling on campus?
On campus, we do a pretty good job recycling bottles and cans outdoors in the big blue rolling bins, but we are not doing a great job recycling papers in campus and some of the other products that we could be recycling.
So what are some common mistakes that students make?
On recycling outdoors, frequently we get a lot of trash from lunches and pizza boxes, cardboard in our big blue rolling bins. Secondly, we could do a lot better job recycling paper and boxes and things like that.
Well, that's super interesting. And where do our recyclables go?
Our recyclables on campus are collected by Urban Core, and the money that we get from the bottles actually comes back to the school and the Environmental Club, and we donate it to nonprofit organizations.
That's really great. Well, lastly, how can students get involved in recycling?
Students can get involved in recycling by doing a better job in their classroom, recycling paper and their lunch bags and other products that are recyclable. They can also join the Environmental Club and help us recycle on Fridays.
Very nice. Well, Dons, be sure to keep recycling.
When the rains came down in the hollow, playing a new game, laughing and a running, hey hey, skipping and a jumping in the misty morning fog with all our hearts a thumping, and you, my brown eyed girl. And whatever happened to Tuesday and so slow? Gone down the old mine with a transistor radio. Standing in the sunlight laughing, hiding behind a rainbow.
Thanks, team. Remember to recycle, Dons.
Hey, Julia, I noticed you're wearing Converse today.
Yeah, so?
If you had Vans, you could design them like some of our other students on campus. Let's find out more.
Do you like painting?
Yeah.
Do you like Vans?
Yeah.
Then here is Gino.
Yeah.
To find out more.
Yeah.
Good morning, Dons. I'm Gino, and I'm here with Whitney and Leanne to learn a little bit more about an art competition they just participated in. So, Leanne, what was this competition?
It was a competition hosted by Vans, and we got 4 blank canvas shoes, and basically we painted them to fit different themes with different colors.
Awesome. So Whitney, what do you get if you win this competition?
So the Vans company will decide if we get $10,000 towards the art program at our school, or we will get a scholarship to the Laguna College of Art and Design.
Now, Leanne, do you have anything else you would like to add?
Please vote for us when we get in the top 50 so that we can win the whole thing.
And Whitney, how might our viewers come to voting?
We should find out within the next few days if we end up in the next round of 50. And if we do, then I'm sure we'll be able to send out an email to you guys. So please look out for it and vote for us.
Thank you. For CCTV, I'm Gina Luxotti. Back to you in the anchor room.
Thanks, team.
Well, that's all the news we have for you this week. Remember, it's a great day to be a Don.
We'll see you next week.